Practice set 6. Use the shortcut to convert these metric units. You should also use the conversion factor method on several of these same problems too. In problem number 2, they're asking us to convert 2.5 liters to milliliters. If we look at the metric prefixes to use the shortcut method, liters is at the base measurement. We're converting it to milliliters, so we're moving 1, 2, 3 decimal places to the right to convert from liters to milliliters. We'll do that same 3 decimal places to the right on our number. So the given value is 2.5 in liters. To go to milliliters, just as the prefix is indicated, we'll do the same movement, 3 decimal places to the right. The problem is we don't have any more. No problem. We'll put zeros for placeholders. So we've moved 1, 2, 3 decimal places. Our new decimal value is at the end. So to answer this problem, 2.5 liters is equivalent to the value that we just found, 2,500 milliliters. To use the conversion factor method, we will start with the given measurement, 2.5 liters, expressed as a fraction over 1. We'll use the conversion factor that there is 1 milliliter equivalent to 0.001 or 1/1000th of a liter. Expressing this relationship as a conversion factor fraction, the goal would be to eliminate the liters in the numerator, so we will put 1 milliliter in the numerator over the equivalent 0.001 liter in the denominator. The liters do cancel out. Simplifying the fraction, 2.5 times 1 is 2.5. In the denominator, we have 1 times 0.001. Do the indicated division. 2.5 divided by 0.001 gives us a value of 2,500, and the units are milliliters. In problem number 5, they're asking us to convert 450 milliliters to liters. If we go to that metric prefix chart, identify where we are. We're at milliliters. We want to go to liters, which is the base unit. This time we're moving powers of 10 or decimal places to the left. 1, 2, 3 decimal places to the left. We'll do that same movement on the given number. So we have 450 milliliters with the implied decimal place at the end, past the zero. Moving 3 decimal places to the left to convert from milliliters to liters puts our decimal place here in front of the 4. So 450 milliliters using the shortcut method is equivalent to 0.45 liters. If we use the conversion factor method, we start with the given value expressed as a fraction over 1. Using the same conversion factor that we just had in problem number 2, 1 milliliter is equivalent to 0.001 liter. We'll express that as a conversion factor fraction that will eliminate our milliliters, our given unit. To do that, this time our arrangement will have the 1 milliliter in the denominator with the equivalent 1/1000th of a liter in the numerator. Milliliters cancel out, leaving us with multiplication of the two numbers in the numerator. Multiplying 450 by 1/1000th gives us 0.045 or 0.045 of a liter, the equivalent value.